Welcome to my religious life video blog. It's Neilish Music, and guess what? And this is why it happens all the time. That's a little bit snippet of Because He Lives, and why? Because Easter is coming, and that song, Because He Lives, Matt Maher wrote this song. So is Bill Gaither. Is you want to hear it again? Just listen to this. Alright, that's enough. So, we're gonna talk about Easter. Because what that means? It means that it means Resurrection Sunday. I know you might think it's but I know you think you seen it all is a festival. Well, guess what? It is a festival and holiday celebrating the resurrection of Jesus from the dead, and it describes in the New Testament as having occurred on the third day of his burial, after his crucifixion by the Romans at Calvary. And it is the culmination of the passion of Jesus. It preceded by Lent. Could be a 40-day period of fasting, prayer, and penance that we just talk about last month and this month for my religious life video blog. Do this at Zozo Coffee House last month and this month, whatever it is. But right now, here's why. Because Lent is over. Because I tell you one thing, it's Ash Wednesday and Lent is over with right now. So most of the Christians to the week before Easter as Holy Week, and it contains the day of the Easter Triduum. Yeah, you guessed it. And here's why. We talk about this Palm Sunday, waving palm branches, and people are shouting Hosanna to the King and all that stuff. But what about Monday, Thursday? Just remember that we talked about this last Thursday during my religious life. It commemorating the Monday, Thursday, and it could be the Last Supper. And, but what about Good Friday, as I said this before on my religious life and last Friday about Good Friday, because it commemorating crucifixion and death of Jesus. So what comes next on our list of things is the Great Easter Vigil that we just did. let's talk about last night about this one, because it makes a lot of sense about Easter and all that stuff. So who knows? Well, who knows, could be get inside 50 days of Easter, so should be fun. Anyways, enough of that. Let's talk about this. This is what happens. The New Testament states that the resurrection of Jesus, which is Easter celebrates its foundation of the Christian faith and the resurrection established Jesus as the powerful Son of God, is cited as proof that God will judge the world in righteousness. For those who trust in Jesus' death and resurrection, death is swallowed up in victory. And if any person who chooses to follow Jesus receives a new birth into the living hope through the resurrection of Christ from the dead. And that's why through faith in the working of God, for those of you who follow Jesus, are spiritually resurrected with him, so that they may walk in a new way of life and receive eternal salvation. So, who knows that Easter is linked over to Passover and Exodus from Egypt. It's been recorded inside the Old Testament. Just remember that. The Last Supper, and the sufferings and the crucifixion of Christ that precedes the resurrection. But according to the New Testament, which you get inside Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 through 10, a little bit later. But anyways, Jesus gave the Passover meal and a new meeting inside the upper room. During the last supper, he prepared himself and his disciples for his death. He identifies the matzah, that means bread, and the cup of wine as his body soon sacrificed and his blood would be shed. That's why Paul wrote this. Says, to get rid of the old yeast, and that you may have a new batch without yeast, as you really are. Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed. But what about the Passover requirement to have no yeast in the house? And the, allegory of Jesus as the Paschal Lamb. Just remember that Gospel of John says this, and it interprets the chronological synoptic Gospels about this. You guessed it. Who knows? That's Easter, what is all about this one. Get this part from Matthew chapter 28, verses 1 through 10. It says, after the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb, and suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven and rolled back the stone and sat on it. And that's why his appearance was like lightning, and his clothing as clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But Jesus said to the woman, do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. for he has been raised. As he said, come, see the place where he laid. Then go quickly, tell his disciples that he has been raised from the dead. As I play this opening monologue of this song, Glad, of this singing a cappella group, Glad, Easter song, and I cannot believe my eyes and ears. You ought to know by now, as the opening introduction knows it from, trust me about that. Anyways, everybody knows that we're talking about this raised from the dead, and quickly you had to tell the disciples all that. And then what comes next? Yes, indeed, he's going ahead of you to Galilee, and there you will see him. This is my message to you, for you. So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy, and ran to tell the disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, greetings. And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. And Jesus said to them, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. Now, here's a subject for you, because, you know, Easter is, you guessed it, finally, it's not about Easter eggs, or it's not about candy, or showing your loved ones, going out Sunday Easter brunches and all that stuff, but it has something, because here's why. The stone just been removed. So that means the two Marys come to see the tomb earlier on the first day of the week. That means the first of the Lord's Day. And there was an earthquake. Because the earthquake, and it rolls right back the stone from the door of the tomb and tries to sit on it. And what happens next? The guards is being shaken by the fear, and it has become dead, and that's why the stone is rolled back. And you know why? Because the outsiders try to let it in, and not to let the inside out, and that has already happened. If you've seen AD, the Bible Continues, last year, well, year ago, well, I seen this AD, the Bible Continues, on NBC.com. I bet it's on demand, so you can see it as well. And probably you've seen the Passion of Christ. That is last couple of years ago, so, well, you know what that means. It means I've seen it all, and you guessed it. Now, Savior is risen for the dead. And why? Because the angels, because the angels tells the women not to be afraid. But that the crucified Jesus has been risen, and they are trying to relay this good news to tell the disciples, and that Jesus will meet them again in Galilee. Now, here's the last part of this one, because Could be a suddenly a reunion starts. Well, you guessed it. Now listen closely. This is the last part. Emotionally, it's between fear and great joy. And they run to tell the disciples and are being met by Jesus, whose opening comment says, rejoice. They hold him and worshiped him. He repeats the angel's instructions not to fear. Do not be afraid about this one. And go to the disciples and tell that he will meet them in Galilee. That's why Easter is all about. About the tomb and all that. Because after Palm Sunday all the way up to, you guessed it, Easter Vigil is over with. Easter Sunday's coming with. This is what happens. You know why? Because it happens again and again and again. Because the moral of this religious life video blog story is this, because you know, that's why with the resurrection, so it's Christmas memorial for Easter Sunday and all that is happening right now. So who knows? Because if it wasn't for Ash Wednesday, it goes all the way up to Easter Vigil. Guess what? As I said, it's a festival. It's a holiday. By celebrating the resurrection of Christ has been dead, it describes it. You know, it reminds me of that song, Christ is Risen, from Matt Maher. And, because I heard this over and over and over again. And you're going to hear this song before we say goodbye. Why? Because Christ is risen, the Lord is risen indeed. And now everybody knows. Because you have to get ready for 50 days of Easter. So who knows? And that's why we're going to leave you with this one song by Matt Maher. It's called Christ is Risen. And once you picture yourself in realizing this song will make sense to you for Easter. Because Christ is risen from the dead. Let it rise from the grave. Listen to this. Let no one caught in sin remain inside the lie of inward shame. We fix our eyes upon the cross and run to him who showed great love and bled for us. Freely you bled for us. Christ is risen from the dead, trampling over death by death. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Christ is risen from the dead, we are one with him again. Come awake, come awake, come and rise up from the grave. Beneath the weight of all our What else can we say? For now, happy Easter, and Christ is risen from the dead. He's risen indeed, hallelujah. And that's my religious life video blog story, and I'm sticking to it.